Hi friends, welcome back to my channel, Universe of Physics. Now I am going to discuss one more concept, that is electron emission. Let us discuss about the concept, that is electron emission. Then what do you mean by electron emission? That is the emission of electrons from the metal surface, or the liberation of the electrons from the metal surface, we called as electron emission. That is the liberation of electron, the liberation of electron from the metal surface, from the substance is known as electron emission. That is the liberation or emission of electrons from a metal surface or from a substance, we called as electron emission. And we know that there are four types of electron emission. Let us discuss one by one. That is, which are the four types of electron emission? That is, first one, thermionic emission, and second one, photoelectric emission, and third one, field emission or cold emission, and last one, that is secondary emission. Let us discuss one by one. That is first one, that is there are four types of electron emission. That is thermionic emission, and second one, photoelectric emission, and third one, field or cold emission, and fourth one, that is secondary emission. Let us discuss one by one. That is, first one, thermionic emission. Then what do you mean by thermionic emission? The process of emission of electrons from a metal surface by heating that metal surface. So in this process, we can get the electrons from the metal surface by heating the metal surface. That process we called as thermionic emission. And whatever the electrons we get from this process, we called as thermal electrons. What do you call that electrons? That is, what is thermionic emission? The emission of electrons from the metal surface by heating that metal surface. And whatever the electrons ejected during that time, we called as thermal electrons. And in this case, the number of electrons, thermal electrons liberated from the metal surface depends on nature of the substance or nature of the metal surface, and also it depends on temperature of the substance. It depends on the number of thermal electrons liberated from the metal surface depends on, that is, nature of the substance or metal surface, nature of the substance, and also it depends on temperature of the substance temperature of the substance, temperature of the substance. This is about thermionic emission. Next we shall discuss about photoelectric emission. Then what do you mean by photoelectric emission? We already discussed about this photoelectric emission in detail. Let us discuss briefly about this photoelectric emission. That is, it means in case of photoelectric emission, again it is the process of emission of electrons from the metal surface. It is the process of emission of electrons from the metal surface by radiation or light of suitable frequency incident on that metal surface. That is the emission of electrons, the emission of electrons from a metal surface by the incidence of light of suitable frequency is known as photoelectric emission. That is the emission of electrons from a metal surface and the radiation of suitable frequency or preferable frequency falls on that metal surface, we call it as photoelectric emission. And whatever the electrons are ejected in this case, we call it as photoelectrons. What do you call those electrons? That is photoelectrons. And in this case, the motion of these photoelectrons in a circuit that constitute photoelectric current. That is, photoelectric current is due to motion of these photoelectrons. And in this case, the number of photoelectrons ejected from the metal surface depends on, that is, as usual, that is, that depends on nature of the substance. First one, nature of the substance, and also it depends on intensity of incident light. It depends on, that is, in case of photoelectric emission, the number of electrons ejected depends on nature of the metal surface or substance, and also it depends on intensity of the incident light. This is about photoelectric emission. Let us discuss the third one, field or cold emission. Then what do you mean by field or cold emission? That is the process of getting electrons from a metal surface by applying strong electric field across the metal surface. We call this field emission. That is the process of emission of electrons by applying strong electric field across the metal surface is known as field or cold emission. That is, in this case, to get the electron from the metal surface, the range of the electric field is around 10 power 8 volt per meter, around 10 power 8 volt per meter. That is 10 power 8 volt per meter. This is the strength of the electric field applied across the metal surface. And whatever the electrons in this case liberated, that depends on, as usual, that is nature of the substance, that is nature of the metal surface, nature of the metal surface, and also it depends on strength of the electric field, depends on strength of the electric field applied across the metal surface. This is about field or cold emission. And last one, that is secondary emission. Then what do you mean by secondary emission? That is the emission of electrons from a metal surface by the bombardment of fast moving electrons. It is a process of getting electrons from the electrons only. That is, it is the process of getting electrons from a metal surface by the bombardment of fast moving electrons on that metal surface, we called as, that is secondary emission. That is the process of emission of electrons from the metal surface by the bombardment of fast moving electrons on that metal surface is known as secondary emission. And whatever the electrons incident on that metal surface, we called as primary electrons. And the electrons ejected from the metal surface by the bombardment of primary electrons, we called as secondary electrons. And in this case, the number of electrons ejected from the metal surface depends on as usual, that is nature of the metal, along with, that is the number of primary electrons. That is, first one, it depends on nature of the metal surface along with number of primary electrons. It depends on number of primary electrons. This is about four types of electron emission. That is thermionic emission. That is let us discuss briefly, that is what is electron emission. The emission of electrons from the metal surface when by using suitable energy, we called as electron emission. There are four types of electron emission based on type of energy we are going to use to get the electron from the metal surface. That is first one, thermionic emission. Second one, photoelectric emission. Third one, field or cold emission. And fourth one, secondary emission. According to thermionic emission, that is, it is the process of getting electrons from the metal surface by heating that metal surface. And whatever the electrons ejected, we call as thermal electrons. And number of thermal electrons liberated from the metal surface depends on, that is, nature of the metal surface along with the temperature of the substance. In case of photoelectric emission, that is the emission of electrons from a metal surface by incidence of light of a suitable frequency on that metal surface, we called as, that is, photoelectric emission. In and whatever the electrons ejected, we called as photoelectrons. And the number of photoelectrons ejected depends on, that is, nature of the substance along with the intensity of the incident light. And third one, that is field or cold emission. This is the process of getting electrons from your metal surface by applying strong electric field across that metal surface, which is in the range of 10^8 volt per meter. And in this case, the number of electrons liberated depends on, that is, nature of the substance along with that is the strength of the electric field applied across the metal surface. And fourth one, that is secondary emission. It is the process of getting electrons from a metal surface by the bombardment of fast moving electrons. Those fast moving electrons we call as primary electrons, and whatever the electrons ejected from the metal surface we call as secondary electrons. Here the number of electrons liberated depends on, that is, nature of the substance and also primary electrons, number of primary electrons. This is about types of electron emission. And one more concept, that is the energy of the electron, or energy we can express in terms of electron volt. Then what is electron volt? What is electron volt? What is electron volt? That is the energy gained or acquired by an electron when it is accelerated through a potential difference of 1 volt. We call as 1 electron volt. Electron volt is the energy gained. Energy gained or acquired. By an electron, when it is accelerated through a potential difference of one volt, is known as 1 eV. That is, what is electron volt? Here electron volt is the energy gained or acquired by an electron when it is accelerated through a potential difference of 1 volt. And it is given by, that is, E is equal to R, W is equal to dV into Q. That is, dV is equal to 1 volt into Q is the charge on the electron, that is 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb. That is 1.6 into 10 power minus 90 joules. That is 1 electron volt is equal to how many joules? That is 1 eV. 1 eV is equal to 1.6 into 10 power minus 90 joules. Here electron volt is the energy. Our energy we can also express in terms of eV. That is 1 electron volt is defined as, it is the energy gained or acquired by an electron when it is accelerated through a potential difference of 1 volt. We call as 1 electron volt. And 1 electron volt is equal to how many joules? 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 joules. Okay friends, this is all about electron emission and types of electron emission and regarding electron volt. Okay. If you like this video, please share and subscribe. Okay, thank you.